Rock Bolding, Matt Doherty with you. And Matt, look at the game summary.
Well, that
UNCG having trouble making baskets, just 10 made shots in the game.
Excuse me for stepping on you. That's the credit of Furman coming in locked in. I tell you what, the adjustment Coach Ritchie has made by changing the starting lineup, all right, having Slauson and Mounts come off the bench, I think ignited the energy. Colin Kenny and Garrett Heen have brought some great energy, and I think that's helped on the defensive end. And then that's locked up Isaiah Miller. Isaiah Miller's taken some bad shots. That's leading to transition buckets for Furman. Alex Hunter having a heck of a first half.
So what kinds of adjustments do you expect to see from UNCG here in the second half, down 12?
I think they've got, as simple as it sounds, you've got to reverse the ball and cut harder. I don't think they're cutting very hard. I think defensively they've given up way too many backdoor cuts. And so keep the ball out of the elbow on the defensive end. Keep them in front of you. Don't let get the backdoor cuts. And then the unforced turnovers. Their turnovers, they've had... Nine turnovers led to 13 points.
So UNCG with the ball to begin the second half. Alley-oop to Miller and lays it in.
Well, that's not a bad start. Giddy up.
And for Miller, his fourth basket, his eighth point of the game. Here's Alex Hunter with the ball. He had a game-high 12 points in the first half. He came in averaging 10 a game. He had 12 in the first 20 minutes. Bothwell gets free and scores.
See, that's just a breakdown by Miller. You're two passes away. You need to be off in the lane a little bit more and not get beat on a back cut.
It's a UNCG team that has won 8 straight games overall. It's won 7 straight on the road. Its last road loss, December the 10th. Hunter fouled by Kenny, and Hunter will head of the line and shoot 2. Here's a look at that last basket.
Yeah, watch Miller, number one. He's gotten beaten. This will be his third time on a backdoor cut. He's two passes away. His guy, now that's the action, the Princeton action, coming to a screen, and then they refuse the screen and cut backdoor with an open post. Now that's terrific basketball. I love watching that stuff right there. And that was, I believe, Noah Gurley with the assist. You have 5 guys that can pass, handle, and shoot the ball. And if you cut hard, you can cut harder. You know where you're going, and it's a read. If Miller's up too high, you're going back door. If he pops down low and blocks the cut, then you're coming off a down screen.
2 free throws made by Hunter. Inside for Furman is Hunter. Now back out. Jaheen, Hunter's 3. Fight for the rebound. Bothwell had it. Still loose and picked up by Abdul Salam for UNCG. Here comes Miller in rhythm. Allegri, his 3 is blocked. Taken by Bothwell.
That's a terrible shot. A terrible shot. I'd have a sub at the bench right now. First side contested 3. Your shot's blocked. You're either taking... I say this to 2 players. You're either a bad shooter or you're taking bad shots. Which one is it? Now, Allegri's a good shooter. That's a bad shot. He needs to come out of the game.
Heen doubled, turns it over. Number 12 in the game on Furman. Here's Miller. Hunter steps inside and missing the 2. The shot's just not falling here tonight for UNCG, shooting just 28% in the first 20-plus minutes. Gurley lost it. And out of bounds to UNCG.
Wes Miller has a lot more patience than I do, keeping Allegri in the game. Yeah, he's got strong hands. Miller has strong hands, and that was a good, I thought, a draw charge, but the referee obviously doesn't agree with me up in the stands, but Abdul Salam stepped in and drew a charge. What is...
Bad pass again, over and back. Another turnover on the Spartans, number 10 in the game.
Coach Miller, patience. Maybe that's why his hair hasn't gone gray yet.
There's Coach Miller. You talked about it early in the game, Matt. You recruited Miller when he was a high school player. You were as a college coach. And what do you remember about Miller, the player in high school, and what do you like about him as a head coach?
Well, he was roommates with Rashad McCants, who was an All-American that we recruited to North Carolina. We didn't have a scholarship for Wes, so we talked about a walk-on situation. And he's just, what do you expect? He's a coach on the floor, but he was a really good shooter from range. And he ended up going to James Madison.
Miller with a two-hand slam and does a chin-up. No technical foul. They play on, and Miller starting to heat it up. He now is in double figures with 10.
Back to Wes Miller. He stayed at James Madison for 1 year, then transferred to North Carolina and was a big part of their success when Coach Williams first got there. Now this is the athlete called Isaiah Miller. Active hands. I mean, he's 6 foot. Now, he did a little chin up, all right? Referee might call a techno, but he was really protecting himself from getting undercut. That is unbelievable. I couldn't do that on a low basket.
Slauson wide open for three, and down it goes for Jalen Slauson. His second three of the game. He has 8, and Furman's lead is 11.
Obviously, major mix-up on defense to give Slauson such an open look.
Traveling on, Abdul Salam slipped on some moisture on the floor, and it goes back over to Furman.
Let's look at this defense on UNC Greensboro. Abdul Salam just went with the wrong guy. I mean, that's what happens when you're 5 out. They did a horn set, pick and roll. He's trying to help on the roller, and then his man's wide open for a 3-point shot. The best way to defend that, I think, is just switch it.
Here's Mounts, back to Bothwell, driving baseline, draws 3 defenders. Pesky defense inside, out of bounds off of UNCG.
UNCG is really good at forcing the ball to the baseline because that's where their help is coming. Again, a big Roy Williams, Dean Smith staple.
Bothwell, his 3, short. Out of bounds to UNCG. Well, it's a UNCG team that has struggled here tonight. It's on a current 8-game winning streak, and Wes Miller said the last 2 weeks, he says it sounds cliche, but his team has gotten not just a little bit better in practice the last 2 weeks, but it's gotten better in practice every day this year.
Well, and that starts with Isaiah Miller. He bragged about Isaiah Miller's energy. He's never had a bad day. He's coachable. His teammates like him, low ego guy. So when your best player brings that kind of energy to the floor every day, no wonder your team's getting better.
Timeout on the floor, 15:45 to go. Take it away, Matt.
There's Wes Miller. He's pretty cool and calm, but obviously frustrated with his team's play in the second half.
Back in Greenville, 41-30, Furman leads it by 11. Perhaps the most well-known Furman basketball player of all time. He wore number 28 in the early 1950s. Frank Selvey holds the NCAA Division I record for the most points scored in one game. He scored 100 points in a game against Newberry College. Matt, it was 67 years ago this week.
That's really amazing. Like, to score 100 points is hard to do, right? Will Chamberlain did it in the NBA. But how do you score 100 on the button? Like, you wonder if you're at the foul line and you have 2 foul shots. Do you make the first and miss the second? Because 100 sounds a lot better than 101 to me. I don't know. I've never scored more than 30 in a college game. I don't know how to score 100. That is an amazing, historic moment for Furman University.
He took 66 shots. He made 41 of those 66. He was 18 of 22 at the free throw line. And he says that about 8 or 9 of those jumpers would have been 3-pointers back then if they had the 3-point line in that day. So he would have had theoretically 108 or 109 points in the game if they had the 3 back then.
66 shots. Coach Smith allowed me about four a game. 66. I want to know who was coach. I need to. Who was his coach? Might have been like his father-in-law or something like that, or his dad, like Press Maravich and Pete Maravich. Who knows? 66 shots. That's amazing.
And 100 points in the game. At any division, any level, that's doing some balling.
Yeah, I'd love the wooden backboards and the old key. You know, that's why it was called the key. It was a keyhole. Now it doesn't look like a keyhole, but they still call it, well, they call it the lane. They don't call it the key much anymore.
Noah Gurley scores on the other end. Hunter's three. That's off the mark. The rebound by Gurley for Furman. Furman has lost three of its last four, including two in a row, making a two of its last three, trying to fight back, start a new winning streak here today in the Timmins Arena. That's a turnover on Furman, number 14. There comes Miller, trying to get something going here for UNCG. Down 13 with inside 15 minutes to go.
That was textbook defense on the back door by Miller. Snapping his head, using his other hand, knocking away the bounce pass.
Rebound, Koval lays it in. Aiden Koval, 7-1 senior from Prosper, Texas, his first two. And UNCG, despite the low shooting percentage, hanging in there, down 11.
Well, what was Coach Ritchie's biggest concern? Is turnovers when you have the lead. They were up 49-40 against Wofford with 10 minutes to go, and the bottom dropped out. They had 9 unforced turnovers that led to transition baskets, and they lost the game. So I know that's going on. That's his thought right now, going in the back of his head, is he's thinking about turnovers.
Miller, wraparound pass to Hunter. Doesn't get the bounce. Out of bounds to the Paladins.
Watch Miller, Isaiah Miller, not Wes Miller. Wes is fired up, and I would be too, because I thought that was a blocking foul. Anyway, watch his head turn. I call that a quick head. Miller snaps his head and should look over his left shoulder. However, he didn't. It was just a bad pass by Slauson. Slauson threw the ball to his and hit him in the back of the heel. So those are the unforced turnovers that Coach Ritchie's worried about.
Gurley fouled on his way to the hoop. He's fouled by Koval. That's his second, and he will head to the line and shoot two. There's Furman bench. And we might mention that Rob Swanson, a walk-on for the team, just found out after walkthrough today that his dad's open-heart surgery went well. He's recovering in the ICU. And Mom is taking care of him, and he said he wants to watch the game tonight on ESPNU. So, Mr. Swanson, we hope you're enjoying the game.
Dr. Swanson, he's a dentist in Myrtle Beach.
That's
yeah,
right.
He came, he's in ICU, and he's getting on the nurses saying, I need to see ESPNU this evening because Furman is playing UNC Greensboro. You know he's feeling better. Get well soon.
McGinnis rims out that three. Heen has the rebound. It's out of bounds. It stays with UNCG.
That's a nice stroke. McGinnis has a nice, tight stroke. I love the way the ball rolls off his hands, shooting 36% from the three-point line for the year. And in the last seven-game winning stretch, shooting almost 39% from the three-point line.
Koval missing the three. Rebound mounts for Furman. Furman led by 12 at the break. It leads by 13 right now, coming up on 13 minutes to go.
See, that was excellent pick and roll defense where they call it icing. They're not letting the ball handler get to the pick and roll.
Pugh finds an opening. Left hand, no. Rebound by UNCG. Kobe Langley. Long outlet pass to McGinnis. McGinnis gets free inside. Reverse, no. Out of bounds to Furman.
That's too hard a shot. That's a hard shot. That's a freshman shot. Terrific freshman, but that's a freshman shot. You say, well, I can make that in high school. Well, this isn't high school.
And plenty of time to go in this game, Matt. UNCG down 13, not hitting shots. But what kind of offense should Wes Miller want to see here from his team?
What kind of offense? You want to try again. if you stop them on defense, then you can run against an unset defense, okay? If you don't, then you've got to move the ball side to side and soften up this defense with some pin downs because they do slough. And somebody's got to start making some outside shots because they're only shooting 14% for the game from the three-point line.
Out of bounds off of UNCG. Stays with Furman with 10 to shoot. The Furman Paladins shooting exactly 50% for the game, 19 of 38. UNCG just 27%, 13 out of 47.
I think another thing is UNC's got to get fouled. They've only, both teams have taken four foul shots. But the best way to come back in a game is to score while the clock is stopped. And to do that, you need to get fouled.
As they wipe up some moisture on the floor. 10 to shoot on the shot clock. Here's Heen. Bothwell in the lane. Fadeaway shot. And crawls off the rim. Rebound by Johnny Lawrence. And he's fouled. He'll hit the line and shoot two.
They are very aggressive on the offensive boards. They only have four offensive rebounds, but they're active and they've tipped out a bunch.
So Johnny Lawrence will go to the line. 6'6", redshirt freshman from Orlando, Florida. He is a perfect 4-4 at the line this year, making 5 of 5. We'll have another full day of college hoops across all of our networks Saturday, and we start with Indiana and number 4 Ohio State, who has won 4 straight. Noon Eastern on ESPN. Then it's a Big 12 battle between number 7 Texas Tech and number 2 Baylor, one of only 2 undefeateds left. Both of these games are streaming live on the ESPN app, so you can watch anywhere.
That app is awesome.
Abdul Salam on the way in. He scores his first 2 of the game. I was going to ask you about the ESPN app, being the basketball fanatic.
I love it.
Hoopaholic that you are.
Oh, my gosh. I mean, you can watch, like, games all day. And then, you know, when you can watch replays of games. Not been a great thing for my marriage, but I love watching hoop. And I've got an iPad. I just live on that thing.
11:41 to go. Timeout on the floor. It's Furman in the lead by 13. Back in Greenville, here's a look at the AP Top 10. Matt, can anyone beat Gonzaga?
Oh, I think so. I think Baylor could beat them. Michigan, Gonzaga has obviously played great all year long. The problem with Baylor and Michigan, they've had some major pause issues with COVID. So as we talked earlier, how does that impact the rhythm of the season? That could be an issue. But, you know, it's tough going into the NCAA tournament undefeated. And sometimes you'd rather lose a game before you get ready for March Madness.
So Gonzaga 18-0, Baylor 17-0, the lone 2 remaining unbeatens in college basketball. And Juwan Howard doing a good job in Ann Arbor, 13-1.
Doing a great job, but I think they just started another pause, that's hard to do. That's hard to manage. I've talked to coaches Bob McKillop at Davidson. He was my high school coach. I worked for Bob at Davidson when he first started. And, you know, what do? You have 5 days in isolation, then you can bring the players back. You do a lot of Zoom calls, but, you know, there's no way you can maintain the rhythm of the season. And that's something that Coach Ritchie talked with us about last night.
Yeah, speaking of Coach Ritchie, he said that right now during this pandemic, there's no better time for coaches right now to lead their programs through this pandemic. Matt, if you were coaching today, running a program, what would your message be to your players and your team about handling and going through this pandemic?
Well, I've talked to some teams. I've talked to Harvard Lacrosse. I've talked to Michigan Lacrosse. I run a coaching practice, a leadership practice. And you always have to look at the positive. What is the positive? One, you're getting to play college basketball during this pandemic. A lot of people are, you know, not doing that. They're maybe out of work. They may be in the hospital. So you're getting to play college basketball. Yes, it's unfortunate, but it could always be worse. I think anytime you're dealing with some adversity, it's about perspective. All right, and now, okay, guys, we can't micromanage you sometimes, especially if your team is during a pause. You have to manage yourselves. You have to lead each other. This is where your leadership will have an opportunity to grow. So that's how I would challenge my team.
Moving screen, offensive foul, Angelo Allegri, his first. And they go back the other way.
Allegri's had a little bit of a rough stretch. I'd look for UNCG to turn up the full court pressure when they have a chance. Maybe on a made foul shot or after a made field goal. But first, you got to get stops.
Slauson, open for a three for a moment, drives inside, can't hit it, fight for the rebound, controlled by Bothwell, Hunter's three, rims in and out, rebound by Allegri for UNCG. Two good looks and nothing to show for it. Allegri in rhythm of three. And the rebound by Slauson for Furman.
Yeah. Furman's really taking advantage of Abdul Salam. They're really putting him in an awkward spot for a big to try out and go out and guard Slauson, who really handles the ball like a three-man.
Bothwell backs in on Keyshawn Langley. Strong move, missing the shot. Rebound UNCG. It has numbers, 5-on-4. Miller all the way. They wave off the shot, fouled on the floor before he went to the hoop.
Well, that's what I talked about earlier. Let's get to the foul line, score points while the clock is stopped, but they calling that on the floor. I thought that might have been an opportunity for an N1, but I'm sitting here about 90 feet from the floor.
And a steal by by Furman. Turnover on UNCG. Anderson, shot might have been partially blocked, but a loose ball foul called on the floor on UNCG on Muhammad Abdul Salam, and that's his third.
I don't think Coach Ritchie was real happy with that shot in transition. That's why the young man is coming out.
So Anderson out, Clay Mounts back in.
Yeah, Joe Anderson taking that contested three in transition is not a wise move with a 13-point lead with about 10 minutes to go.
Shot for three goes in for Alex Hunter. Actually, it's a long two. Long two, his first 2 points of the second half. He has 14 for the game. And Furman, again, matching its biggest lead of 15. Miller inside, Abdul Salam, series of moves, blocked by Gurley, taken by Hunter, and Furman wants to run.
How about
Gurley in the corner, mounts a three, over the back, rebound controlled by Bothwell, shot clock resets to 20.
How about Furman's defense, blocking shots? They now have 6 blocks.
Hunter, step back three, book it.
Timeout.
Timeout, Wes Miller and UNCG. UNCG. 9-16 to go, and Furman leads it by 18.
There's the step back by Hunter, showing range. He's hot.
We understand an upside-down world, but they're writing us off before we get to the starting line. A stalled generation? Who do you think is going to fix all this? We will, because our future is the future. So we're going to build bridges and hospitals in a day and feed those left in the cold. We're going to do all this and more because we have an appointment with destiny.
So you're a business that's thriving, but then, don't just bounce back, bounce forward with serious and reliable gig speed internet. But is it secure? Sure, it's secure.
So how do I do this?
We do this together. Bounce forward with Comcast Business.
Here's our SEC Big 12 Super Tuesday doubleheader on ESPN and the ESPN app at 7 Eastern, 14 and 5. Arkansas heads to Lexington to take on Kentucky at Rupp Arena. Then it's the matchup of the night to the Big 12. Number 14, West Virginia, squares off against number 7, Texas Tech in Lubbock. Games are on ESPN and the ESPN app.
Eric Musselman's done a terrific job at Arkansas. He's a lifer. Dad was a great coach. Eric's coached in the NBA. He's coached at all different levels and really bringing Arkansas back to prominence in the SEC.
So UNCG ball, again, this is a team that's on an 8-game winning streak overall. It's won 7 straight on the road. But struggling tonight from the floor and from three-point range. It has 14 turnovers in the game. And there's an alley-oop lob to Koval, missing it. And nothing going right from the field for UNCG tonight.
Well, that's just a home run play. I mean, it's not clear-cut. You can't try to make a home run play. And then he gets beat on backdoor. Miller is not having a great game. Throws it away, gets beat backdoor again. That's probably like the fourth or fifth time he's gotten beaten backdoor.
19 points for Alex Hunter. It's a game high. He had 15 points and 6 assists in his last game 2 nights ago against Wofford in the loss. Here's Koval at 3. That rims out. Rebound Gurley.
13% from the three-point line for the Spartans. Not going to get it done.
Hunter in the corner. Fight for the rebound. McGinnis clears for UNCG in the Miller's hands. Trying to get something going here. It's Furman by 20. Miller inside and scores.
No, great individual effort, but he was going 1-on-4. Furman in was great position to slow down the break. Give Miller credit making a tough shot.
Miller now with 12 points. He's had to earn everything he scored here tonight for the preseason SoCon Player of the Year. Shot clock at 10. Kenny trying to create. Heen into Hunter's hands with 5 to shoot. Hunter lost it. They got to put it up quickly. Heen does, and he scores!
Oh, that's a backbreaker. Really good defense by UNCG. Loose ball, picks it up. Lays it in just before the shot clock expires.
Miller. Off the mark. Rebound Gurley.
He shoots a hard ball. I don't see the rotation on that basketball. You know, you want to see if you don't make it cleanly, a swish, that it bounces and it's soft. His hits the rim and bounces hard off the goal.
Foul on Miller, his first. As we go to break.
Let's watch Miller on defense. I think this is his fourth time he gets beat on a backdoor cut. Dribble at, and he lunges. See, once he lunges at the ball, his man goes backdoor Hunter. Now he goes 1-on-4. The defense is set, pretty good position. An athletic spin move for a deuce. They still have a chance.
Back in Greenville, Furman leads UNC Greensboro 56-36. There's a look at Alex Hunter, 5'11 senior point guard from Raleigh, North Carolina. 19 points here tonight, Matt, including a couple of threes.
He's looked really good, really confident. I just love the way Furman has come out and responded to a tough loss to Wofford the other night. I think Coach Richie's challenged them, and a guy like Hunter has stepped up.
Big block in transition on D by Jalen Slauson. It's Furman ball leading by 20. Inside, Heen goes up for the jam. He missed it, but he's fouled. He'll head of the line and shoot 2. The foul is on McGinnis, his second.
Let's add to that block total. I think that's 7. A rundown. Old Tayshaun Prince, LeBron James. Look at that athleticism. No quit there. That's what That's what Coach Richie challenged these. You got to play with toughness. You got to play with toughness. They didn't play with toughness on the defensive end the other day against Wofford, and they were a little bit selfish, taking bad shots, trying to make home run plays. Tonight, they responded beautifully, and that is the value of coaching. That is the value of leadership. Coach Richie, one of the top young coaches in the country, along with Wes Miller, both on the 40 under 40 list.
Garrett Heen at the line. He's only a 41% free throw shooter, but Matt, he shoots 72% from the field this year. He came in tonight 39 of 54 from the floor. He's missed only 15 shots all year, and Coach Bob Ritchie says he's a freshman who's really holding his own here this year.
Well, he knows his role. I mean, let's say he's like a Dennis Rodman type. You know, Dennis Rodman wasn't going to shoot, wasn't a good foul shooter. He's going to rebound, defend, and get tip outs on the offensive end. Exactly what Heen does, just a different hair color.
Langley scored the basket and one. His seventh point of the game. He'll head of the line for a free throw. And Coach Miller fired up.
You know, this is a really interesting lesson for, well, let's look back to this one-on-one move. Mounts is on the ball. Pretty good defense, but just better offense. But I think that the thing that's interesting here is Mounts is their second leading scorer. He's only got 2 points tonight, and they're doing it without him. And I think what that message sends is, oh my gosh, you know, we got a pretty good team. They don't need me. I better, you know, get going and be in tune, be aligned with the coach, be aligned with the program, be aligned with the principles, the foundational core values of Furman basketball. Go back door. Dribbles that. You got to go back door. Don't stand.
Seven to shoot. Bothwell one-on-one against Hunter in the lane. Left hand rolls out. Rebound Koval for UNCG. How did that come out of there? It was halfway down.
Physics.
Foul. Away from the ball on Furman Heen. His first.
Now, those are the kind of fouls that are foolish. You don't really need to try to get into a little pushing match, which is what it looked like for me, and that's probably why Coach Richie's taking them out. We don't need those fouls. We don't want to get them any closer to the bonus.
Langley in rhythm of three. Strong, high offensive rebound by Miller. Into Jared Hensley's hands, back to Langley. Langley, one-on-one against Hunter, shot blocked, taken by Furman, it has numbers. Here's Gurley, all the way, shot blocked and out of bounds off of Gurley.
Really good defense by Koval. I like when guys block shots with their left hand when an offensive player is using his right hand. Most players go to their strong hand and sometimes then turn their hip into the offensive player, causing a foul. Very aggressive on the ball screen defense. I like that.
Langley fouled on the jumper. He will shoot two.
All right, so you're down 18 with just under five to go. Coach Smith and what I try to do, and Coach Williams, and I'm sure Wes, you have your ketchup. All right, what is ketchup? All right, it's not what you put on your hamburger. It's your ketchup system. You know, that means that we need to blitz all ball screens. So every time they come off a ball screen, we're going to trap. We're going to try to trap with discipline as much as we can, and we're going to go into our spread offense, which would be, you know, five out or four out with a ball screener, and try to attack the rim for layups, fouls, or open threes. And when we score, we're going to press. This is comeback time. 16 points with less than 5 minutes to go. Here's the press. All right.
Timeout taken by Bob Ritchie and Furman. It's a 30, and we'll keep it right here. Bob Ritchie, three consecutive 23-plus win seasons, back-to-back 25-win seasons in each of the last 2 years. This team lost to Wofford in the SoCon Tournament quarterfinals. It was looking at an NIT bid, and then COVID happened, and, well, we're still in COVID. Two of the best young coaches in the land in the ESPN 40 under 40. The top five coaches, Wes Miller ranked number one, Bob Ritchie number five on the list.
Well, I don't know who's ranking them, but I like that list, and I really feel Wes Miller is destined for another level if he wants it, but he loves the leadership. The president, Kim Record, the AD, of that they've stuck with him and they understand the value of athletics for the growth of UNC Greensboro. And then Bob Ritchie, what he's done here is nothing short of amazing. I've been around the Furman program for a long time when I was an assistant at Davidson. We were both in the Southern Conference, and what he's doing here is really, really strong.
Furman had its 19-game Timmins Arena home court winning streak come to an end on Saturday night, trying to start a new streak here tonight. Right now leads by 16, 4:30 to go. Slauson all the way, throws down a jam.
Slauson peeks at the shot clock, sees 6 seconds, and then he fakes a handoff. His man's showing a little bit, cheating on the handoff, and he turns the corner for a dunk. That kid's a good player.
Miller, air ball three, out of bounds.
All right, watch Slauson, looks at the clock, or he'd already looked at it. He fakes the handoff and turns the corner, and then there's no chance for Keyshawn Langley to help there. He goes on a launch pad. Woof. Darn. Guys are dunking and hanging and getting horizontal.
Ball poked away.
I know Coach Ritchie's not breathing easy. He's like, man, 18 points, 4 minutes to go. We can't turn it over against this press. It's a spot throwing. You can't run. You got to cut to the ball.
Nearly turned it over. Gurley, three on two, whips it in the corner to Mounts. And Furman will work some clock, coming up on 4 minutes to go, and it has an 18-point lead.
And again, we talked about earlier in the back of Coach Ritchie's mind, he had 9 turnovers in the last 10 minutes of the game against Wofford with a lead.
Inside, Mounts lays it in.
Not tonight.
Fourth point for Mounts. Mounts just the 10th player in Furman history with at least 1,000 points, 500 rebounds, and 150 assists in a Paladin career.
For a guy who only had one scholarship offer, not bad.
Langley scored the basket and one. He's in double figures with 10.
Let's look at this last bucket, the drive and the cut. This is where you've got to have discipline and see man and ball. Drive, good help, but then all of a sudden nobody drops down. Again, it's Mr. Miller at the foul line. You got to help.